So what is the measurement of our receivables? So initially, according to PFRS 9, we need to value, okay, our valuation dapat for financial assets should be at fair value plus transaction cost. So that's according to PFRS 9, paragraph 5.1.1. And what is fair value? That would be the transaction price, which is the fair value of the consideration. If it's a short-term receivable, the fair value, okay, this is fair value, is equal to the face amount or the original invoice amount, and the cash flows will not be discounted because it is immaterial. So accordingly, accounts receivable shall be measured initially at face amount or the original invoice amount. So meaning if na ay customer nga nangutang sa atoa, so kung pilay value sa iyahang giutang, mausad na lang atong i-record as accounts receivable. And what would be our subsequent measurement? That would be at amortized cost. And the amortized cost is the net realizable value of the accounts receivable. And what is this net realizable value? That's the amount of cash expected to be collected or estimate or the estimated recoverable amount. So to compute this one, we need the following information. So we'll start with the accounts receivable and then deduct all the allowances. We have the freight charge, sales return, discount, and doubtful accounts. But the most common here is the allowance for doubtful accounts. Muna usual nga deduction from accounts receivable, but if the other three are present, then these are included and you should deduct it from your accounts receivable. Then let's have a review of the common freight terms. So we have FOB, designation muna siya. Okay. Asat atong sang i-edit ha. Designation. Destination is siya. Okay, FOB. Destination. Okay, so here are some of the freight terms. This one is already discussed in the fundamentals of accounting, but this is a review. So we have some of the terms. You have FOB destination, we have the FOB shipping point. So these terms will determine who are the owners of the goods that are shipped in transit. Okay, so goods that are shipped in transit, meaning of in transit is samtang nagbiyahe. Kinsa man ang tag-iya sa goods samtang nagbiyahe. And when do you know kung kita na ba ang tag-iya or dili pa? So if it's FOB destination, the ownership will be vested in the buyer upon receipt. Okay, so meaning if the goods will arrive to the destination, which is sa location sa buyer. Okay, so meaning samtang nagbiyahe pa ang goods, okay, so samtang nagbiyahe pa ang goods pa doon sa buyer, ang tag-iya adto is katupang seller. Nganuman, because mabalhin lang sa buyer ang ownership if ma-receive na ni buyer. Okay, so muna siya FOB destination. If it's FOB shipping point, the ownership will be vested in the buyer upon shipment. Okay, so meaning, kung mo-depart na ang common carrier or ang airplane ba na siya, or ang barko, or ang tricycle, or ang bus, from the shipping point, point of shipment, asa man siya dapat mo-depart, okay, from the seller nga side. So once nga mugika na siya kitahay, ang shipping point is ang Pantalan. Tay Pantalan sa Cebu, for example. So kung ang shipping point is ang Pantalan sa Cebu, so once mugikan ang barko, okay, mo depart na siya from the shipping point, automatic mabalhin na sa buyer ang ownership. So meaning samtang nagbiyahe ang goods, ang tag-iya na ato is ang buyer. Okay, so balik ta. FOB destination, kaya ang term niya kay FOB destination, the transfer of ownership will happen when it reaches the destination, which is the location of the buyer. So, destination man siya, FOB destination man siya, so matransfer, inag-abot sa destination. FOB shipping point, since shipping point man ang term, so upon shipment, na-transfer na ang ownership. So, balik ta. Sa FOB destination, samtang nagbiyahi ang goods, ang tag-iya sa goods samtang nagbiyahi is ang seller pagihapon. Nga naman, kay mabalhin lang sa buyer, inig-abot sa destination. Sa FOB shipping point, samtang nagbiyahi na ang goods, na-transfer na ang ownership adto sa buyer because upon shipment, na-vest na ang ownership. Okay? And the next two items pertain to who actually paid the freight. Okay? Kinsa may actual nga nibayad sa freight. Sa freight collect, the freight charge on the goods shipped is not yet paid. So, meaning, pagbiyahe sa goods, wala pa bayari ang pliti. So, kanusa aman mabayaran ang pliti, inig-abot na dito sa buyer, i-collect gikan sa buyer. So, therefore, who actually paid the freight, if it is freight collect, it will be paid by the buyer. It will be paid. Yan will man siya because once ma-receive ni buyer or yung i-pick up kintahay dito sa LBC, ay hapan niya bayaran ang pliti. If it's prepaid, since the term is prepaid, gibayaran daan, so naturally, kinsa may mubayad daan sa pliti. So, ang mubayad daan sa pliti kay ang seller. Okay, so again, freight collect and freight prepaid will determine who actually paid for the freight sa pliti. If it's collect, it will be paid by the buyer pag i-picked up na niya or ma-deliver. And freight prepaid is kung gibayaran niya siya daan sa seller. Okay? Then, how do we account for the freight charge? So, example there, okay? So, sometimes, goods are sold FOB destination, but it is shipped as freight collect, okay? So, ito FOB destination, ma-transfer lang ang ownership upon reaching the destination, which is the location of the buyer. So, silbi, samtang nagbiyahi, ang tag-iya paghihapon sa goods kay katong seller. So, sometimes the goods are sold FOB destination but shipped freight collect with the understanding that the buyer will pay for the freight charge and deduct the same when remittance is made by him. On the part of the seller, the freight charge is recorded by debiting freight out and crediting allowance for freight charge. So, di ba, kung FOB destination na siya, ang ruling mang good is kung kinsa'y tag-iya sa goods, samtang nagbiyahe, again, kung kinsa ang tag-iya sa goods, samtang nagbiyahe, siya dapat ang mubayad sa pliti. Okay, again, kung kinsa ang tag-iya sa goods, samtang nagbiyahe, siya dapat ang mubayad sa pliti. So, kinsa gani ang tag-iya sa goods samtang nagbiyahi kung FOB destination. So, ang tag-iya is ang seller. Kaya diba, ma-transfer naman ang ownership if ma-receive na ni buyer. So, samtang nagbiyahi, ang tag-iya si seller. So, balik ta sa akong gingon nga niya, ang rule mang good is kung kinsa ang tag-iya sa goods, diba dapat siya ang mubayad sa pliti. So, FOB destination man, so ang tag-iya kay ang seller samtang nagbiyahi, so dapat siya ang mubayad sa pliti. But what if it's freight collect? Diba? Pag freight collect, kinsa may actual nga nibayad sa freight, that will be the buyer kay i-collect man sa iya ha, pag ma-receive na niya ang goods. So, nga nag-contradict nga ang tag-iya kay ang seller pero i-bayad kay ang buyer. So, unsa may buhaton ana. So, i-offset or i-deduct tong nabayaran ni buyer nga pliti, i-deduct sa iyahang bayaran nun at tong goods nga iyahang gipalit. Okay? So, for example, an entity has a 100,000 accounts receivable. At the end of the accounting period, the terms are 2 over 10 and 30. Are we already familiar on how we read terms, diba? So that's 2 over 10. And 30, so that means you will, or the customer will get 2% discount if the account is paid within 10 days. So the 10 days will count from the time nga napalit siya. So the following day, so that's day 1 until ika-10th nga day. So pag nabayaran na sa customer sa sunod sa 10 days from the date of purchase, so na-discount nga 2%. So it's FOB destination and then freight collect. And the customer paid the freight charge of 5,000. Of course, ang customer ang mubayad kay freight collect na siya. So what would be the entry? So to record the sale, so that's accounts receivable 100,000, freight out 5,000, di ba? Kita may tag-iya, so kita may dapat mo record sa freight out, and mag-credit tag sales 100,000, and we have the allowance for freight charge. And when we are able to collect the sale, okay, the accounts receivable, they rather within the discount period. So there's a sales discount of 2,000. That's 2% of 100,000. We close allowance for freight charge, and then we credit the accounts receivable ng 100,000, and we have cash of 93,000. Then we have another deduction from the gross receivables to get the net realizable value is the sales returns. So when we're talking about returns, so diba giuli sa customer because it's either they're not happy with what they purchase or it does not meet what they need or sayup nyo na to ang napadala sa ilahang goods. So example, an amount of 50,000 of the total accounts receivable at year end represents selling price of goods that will be probably return. So this is an estimation of the probability nga na ay returns. So what is our entry? So debit sales returns and credit allowance for sales returns. Then we have discounts. So discounts are reduction from the invoice price. So this is resulting from prompt payment. What is a prompt payment? Meaning sa'yo ni bayad. So as incentive for paying it early, then there would be allowable nga discount. So it's also known as sales discount if we are the seller granting the discount, and it's called as purchase discount if we are the buyer availing of the discount. And it is expressed as 5/10 and 30, or katanggan niya 2/10 and 30, which means that we have 10 days to pay if we want to get 5% nga discount, and the entire amount will be paid within 30 days in case we will not pay within 10 days. Okay. If you like this video, don't forget to click like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to be updated with the latest video lessons. Thank you for watching.